Fantastic. Oh, hi. You just caught me reading over my new novel, Lord of the Rings, which I wrote and J.R.R. Tolkien did not write. Hi, it's Mark Charbon. You might remember me from Mark Charbon's Super Special Investigative Reporting, or from Good Will Hunting, where I was Matt Damon's body double.
Yeah.
I'm here to guide you through the do's and don'ts of HSMUN 2009. Hopefully I can change your can't-do attitude to a can-do one about acting like a diplomat in this conference. Don't believe me? Well, jeez! I hope when you watch this film, that'll change your mind. That's exactly why I hate the Mexicans! Russia, I'd like to respectfully disagree with what you just said, and I think we should be talking about the right to protect instead of a silly little arms race that we have. There's no way that the US should be angry at these Egyptians who were financed by Saudi Arabians, because in fact, if you look at the footage from 9/11, it was an inside job. If you look at the burning point of what happened, of the burning point of airplane fuel, that's way too low for it to in fact burn the steel poles. And if you look at how JFK was shot in the back of the head, there's no chance that Lee Harvey. According to these graphs I've carefully prepared for each and every one of you guys, you can see that according to UN mandate, what's happening in the Sudan is not in fact a genocide. So you should want to look that over, and prepared it a couple nights ago. I didn't know that there was an actual conference going on here. I know I'm supposed to be here, but just right in the back, so it's cool. Don't even. Just carry on. Yeah! My legs are long enough to make that. Just I'll be quiet, I promise. Go back here! I have all my notes, all my graphs. Oh man, just so excited about HSMUN. Golly! Yeah, you know what would be cool beans if I had an unmoderated caucus for 5 minutes. Good? No, I don't even need to vote. I got it. Okay, Iran and China, you want to get on this alliance because we're gonna blow. Caucus Canada, we should join an alliance. UK should come over here too. Russia, no, you stay over there with Iran. I don't want to be talking to you in this little dais, okay? But after the conference, we can converse nicely and have a nice chat about what went on.
Okay then. Well, I think that the situation in Kosovo is important.
Shut up.
About increasing turmoil, I think it's more important.
Thanks.
It's more important that we talk about creating the International C-Lab. C-Lab 2020.
Shut up!
Happening there. but instead we should be talking about a coalition formed against the United States and their form of tyranny inside South America and other places. Thank you.
Why, thank you, Russia, for that point. Any other points, Russia?
Right. Hi, kids. Are you still not convinced on how you should act at the conference? Well, hopefully this clip will change your mind about how you should act and how you should dress. Roll that clip, Jimmy.
All things just keep getting better. You came into my life.
First day of the conference. I'm pretty excited. I've never been to a conference before. Oh man.
No way, Jose. You're not coming dressed like that.
What do you mean?
That is inappropriate dress attire for this HS1 conference. Well, it's strictly said business attire. This is homeless man look. We gotta get you some more threads.
Well, alright, but I can't afford a suit.
Doesn't matter. You don't need to wear a suit. All you need to do is wear a tie and a collared shirt.
Wow! I never knew it could be that easy!
Let's go see what you fit into best! So James, let's talk about what's wrong with what you're wearing right now. Number one, your shirt is clearly not ironed. See how improper the collar is? Number two, you're wearing a polo shirt and not a full-sleeved collar shirt.
Yeah, I kind of slept in today.
Well, that's not appropriate. You should be coming to school early anyways. Number three, you're wearing jeans and sneakers. That is also inappropriate for business attire. Notice what I'm wearing. You don't necessarily have to wear a suit, but you should be wearing a collared shirt, a tie, dress pants, and dress shoes.
Well, somebody told me once that I could just wear a sports coat with a t-shirt underneath. Is that true?
No, only to go to bars wear stuff like that anyways.
Oh, well, I don't want to be one of them.
No, you certainly do not. You should dress with class and represent yourself as if you're representing your country and your school.
Wasn't that keen, delegates? I know I'm convinced. Now you know how to be the top delegate. All it takes is that positive attitude and the willingness to learn. Then you can be the best delegate.